Welcome to RoboGuru online programming course. Today we will look at advanced motion commands. So we will look at making robot perform different actions using advanced motion commands. Let's see. So here are some disclaimers. You can read them. So what we will learn today is advanced motion commands. What happens when we use motion commands and how advanced motion commands work. Then moving robot in a square using advanced motion commands, edge detection robot using advanced motion commands, then obstacle avoidance robot using advanced motion commands, and at last line follower robot using advanced motion commands. And there will be a hybrid robot also that we'll look at. So here is this robot. Suppose consider that it's moving forward. Okay. And suppose a person is here. Okay. Towards the left of the robot. So if you look at the, if he is looking at the left wheel of the robot and robot is moving forward, according to him, the left wheel will be moving in the counterclockwise direction. And if the person is towards the right of the robot, according to him, the right wheel will be moving in the clockwise direction, right? So if the person is right here, okay, if we are using a forward command, okay, there are two things happening according to him. So when we use a forward command, wheel one, which is the left wheel, will move in a counterclockwise direction, and according to him, the right wheel also will move in the counterclockwise direction. Similarly, if we talk about a hard left, right, if we talk about a hard left, then also the left wheel, the first wheel, wheel 1 will be moving in clockwise direction and wheel 2 will be moving in counterclockwise direction. But similarly, if the person is looking from the other perspective, if this person is looking from this side, okay, from the right side, so this whole perspective will change, because then according to him, wheel 1 will move in clockwise direction and wheel 2 will move in clockwise direction. Similarly, for a hard left also, wheel 1 will move in counterclockwise direction and wheel 2 will move in clockwise direction. So everything will be reversed. So this is how we look at motion commands. But the point is why we are not using forward command and why we are using different other motion commands, which is motor 1 clockwise, motor 1 counterclockwise. So like motor 1 clockwise moves motor in clockwise direction. Then motor 1 counterclockwise moves motor 1 in counterclockwise direction. So the point is why we are not using the same forward commands, backward command, left, right, hard left, hard right. Why we are not using is because when we talk about actual robotics, okay, when we actually work on, because right now we are not working on the hardware, we are working on the software. So when we actually work on hardware, definitely we will require certain advanced motion commands, because that time this forward function will not be there. We need to program individual motors individually. I mean, like each motor you need to program that this motor should move clockwise, this motor should move anti-clockwise. Then you will be able to create a motion. Okay, let's see. So first program is write a program to make robot move in a circle using advanced motion commands. Okay, so let's go to RoboGuru and try something. I'll just remove all of this and So first what we will do is we will go to motor robot, then go to configure. And first we will go to motors. Okay. So in this motors, you need to change this motion to mechanism. Okay. Now you will choose this as mechanism. So motor one will be the left motor, motor two will be the right motor. Similarly, first, I think we should remove the sensors also. Sensors are not required in this program. I'll remove the sensors also. If you have added any sensors, then remove them. Now let's write a program for making robot move in a circle. Okay, so what we will do is, so according to advanced motion commands, how these motors work is you need to look them perpendicularly, okay, from side. Okay, if you look from here, and if I want that robot should move forward, okay, according to me, this left wheel should be moving in counterclockwise direction, right? And if I talk about this wheel, this right wheel should be moving in clockwise direction, okay? Then only robot will move forward, okay? Right wheel should be moving clockwise direction, left wheel should be moving in counterclockwise direction, then only we can see that robot will be moving forward. So now, first program is we need to make robot move in a circle. Okay, in order to move it in a circle, there are two commands which needs to be used, which is forward and hard left or hard right. Okay, so let's try that. First, we will use a repeat loop. Okay, and after that, we need to write a command by which robot should move forward for a very less time, then it should turn left. Okay, so in order to make robot move forward, we should make this left command. Okay, we can use this forward command also, but right now it's not available, okay, because we are using mechanism. Right now we will be using advanced motion commands, AMC. Okay, so we want to make this left wheel move in counterclockwise direction. Okay, so we'll go to motor 1 and select motor 1 CCW, which means counterclockwise. Okay, after that we should be turning this right wheel towards in clockwise direction. How we will do that? We will go to motor 2, which is clockwise direction. Okay, so this small command is only to make robot move forward. So if I just run this command, you can clearly see that robot will start moving forward, because here what I've programmed is that motor 1, which is the left motor, it should be moving in counterclockwise direction, in this direction. And if we talk about right motor, it should be moving in clockwise direction. So if it's moving in clockwise and this is moving in counterclockwise, the robot should move forward. So these two commands is a combination or is equivalent to the forward command. Okay, so I've just given a forward command, but in a different form, because that's how robotics works. That's how you need to work on robotics, because as per robotics, you need to give individual commands. Yeah, so robot has started moving forward because we have given a forward command. So this left wheel is moving in counterclockwise direction and this right wheel is moving in clockwise direction, right? So again, let's try. After this, since we have to make this robot move in a circle, we will give a small delay of 200 milliseconds. Okay. After that, we will write a program so that robot turns hard left for a very short time. Okay. Now we need to turn robot hard left. So in order to make robot hard left, we need to make two things. If we look at from the top view, in order to make it hard left, this wheel should move back and this wheel should move forward. Okay, so this wheel should be backward, this wheel should be forward. Okay, in order to make this left wheel backward, what we will do, this wheel should be rotating in clockwise direction. So this is the wheel 1 or the motor 1. We will go to motor 1 and add a motor 1 clockwise. After that, we need to rotate this right wheel towards forward. Okay, in order to make it go forward, this right wheel should be moving forward. Okay, in order to make it go forward, we should be rotating in clockwise direction. Okay, so we will go to motor 2 clockwise. Okay, and for this, we will give a small delay of maybe 20 milliseconds, so that it moves forward and turn. Okay, so this small program is for making robot move forward. Okay, this also is for forward. Okay, this we have written for hard left. So if we run this program, you can clearly will see that this robot should be moving in a circular path. It's very similar to our previous programs, but now we are using advanced motion commands. So this robot is clearly moving in a circle. Okay. Let's try our next program. Next program is write a program to make a obstacle avoidance robot using advanced motion commands using AMC. So in order to make a robot which is an obstacle avoidance robot using AMC, first we need to add a few sensors. Let's suppose we take 3 sensors right now. Okay, first one can be F, second let's take it FLC, third one let's take it FRC. Okay, and all of them should be obstacle avoidance sensors. Okay, so here our robot with sensors is ready. Now it's ready to program. Let's program it. So in order to make an obstacle avoidance robot, we should be using certain conditional statements or while loops. Okay, so I think it's better to use a while loop. So I'll go to loop and add certain conditions that robot, that F is an obstacle. So our point is that if any of the sensor detects that there is an obstacle, it should move back or turn hard left, something like that. So let's try. So F is an obstacle, or we will add a OR operator. Then we will add some more sensors that if FLC is obstacle, if this sensor detects an obstacle, or this sensor detects an obstacle, or this sensor detects an obstacle. So we have added all the 3 conditions here. So if any of these sensor detects an obstacle, what should happen? Robot first of all should move back. Just remove this. We only need forward command. Okay. So this forward command, this is the forward command. Okay. Now we need to write that if these sensor detects an obstacle, what should happen? Let's say robot should move back for maybe 600 milliseconds, then it should turn left or hard left for maybe 200-300 milliseconds. Okay, I think we will require that hard left command. So let's try this, that how we will make it move backward. Okay, so in order to make it go backward, this wheel should be turning, the left wheel, wheel one or the motor one should be turning clockwise direction. So we will add a motor one clockwise. Similarly, in order to make this robot move backward, the right wheel or motor two should be rotating in counterclockwise direction. Okay, so we will add a counterclockwise direction motor two. Okay. And we will write that this is for backward. Okay. Now we will add a delay, a small delay of maybe 600 milliseconds will be enough. You can change this delay also. Then now we need to add a command of hard left. So we already have a command for hard left here. So I'll just copy this and paste it here. And for hard left also, we need to give a small delay. Delay will be of maybe 400. Okay. So if any of these sensor detects an obstacle, robot will move backward for 600 milliseconds. Then robot will move towards hard left for 400 milliseconds. If any of the sensors are not high, if any of the sensor doesn't detect the obstacle, this command will be executed, which is a forward command. So this robot will keep on moving this arena. If it detects the obstacle, it will move back and take a hard left. And again, start moving forward. Let's try that. So robot is moving forward. Sensor hasn't detected anything yet. So first sensor detects, it will move back, take a hard left. Okay. So it will keep on moving like this around this arena. Okay. Maybe it will fall into the edge. Yeah, it will fall around the edge, maybe. Yes. Okay, so we need to add a edge detection also. So our next program is also edge detection. So we need to make a robot move whenever it detects an edge, the robot should move back. We will go to robot configure and we will use only one sensor. We can use three sensors also, not a problem. If you want, we can use all the three also. FLC and FRC. And all these three sensors will be an edge sensor. Okay, save. So here, instead of this part, what we will add is so we will add all the three sensors here. If F is a edge, or if FLC is a edge, or if FRC is a edge. If any of these sensors detects the edge, the robot will move back then for a delay, then to take a hard left. After that, it will keep on moving forward. In order to see that, let's move robot here and rotate it a little bit. Now let's run this program. So here you can see that all the three sensors are pointing downwards. It hasn't detected any edge yet. It's detecting the surface. So whenever it detects a edge, its sensor color will turn to red. And when that edge is detected, robot will move backward, take a hard left, and after that, it will keep on moving forward by these commands. Right, so that's how it's going to work. Similarly, we need to make a line follower robot using advanced motion commands. Okay. So we will place it here and make it turn little 90 degree. Yeah, this is better. So here we will go to robot and change these sensors to maybe none. Here we will use a line sensor, and instead of this position, let's select FL and FR. So according to line following concept, if robot So if a robot, if any of the sensor, if any of the sensor detects that, if right sensor detects that there is an obstacle, there is a line, then robot should turn right. And similarly, if the left sensor detects that it is a line, robot should turn towards left. Okay, so let's try that. We will use a while loop here, or you want to use a if condition also, we can use the if condition. So we'll go to front, then use FL. If FL is a line, robot should move left. Okay, in order to make robot go left, this wheel should be stopped and this wheel should be moving forward. Okay, then only robot will turn towards left direction, right? This wheel, this motor one will be left, and motor, sorry, this is, yeah, this is motor one. Motor one will be stop and motor two will be moving forward. That means if we have to make it go forward, that means clockwise, motor two clockwise, motor one stop. So we'll add a motor one stop and motor two clockwise. Okay, then we will add a one more if or one more while. The condition will be that FR is aligned. Now, in order to make robot move towards right, okay, this wheel, motor two will be stopped and motor one will be moving forward. In order to make it move forward, it will be rotating in counterclockwise direction. So motor one clock counterclockwise, motor two stop, motor one counterclockwise and motor two stop. Okay, and if any of the if both the sensors are not detecting a line, robot should move forward. Okay, let's try this program. I think it should work. Yeah, it's following the line. Okay. So we will go to our programs. What we have learned today is advanced motion commands. What happens when we use motion commands? Then how advanced motion commands work? Then moving robot in a square or circle using AMC, edge detection robot using AMC, obstacle avoidance robot using AMC, and line follower robot using AMC. Now here's a hybrid robot which is both obstacle avoidance robot as well as edge detection robot. So you should try this program. What you need to do in this is you need to select two sensors or maybe three sensors. Two sensors can be used for obstacle avoidance and one sensor can be used as a edge detection. So you need to use a OR operator for all these sensors. So what you will do is obstacle avoidance sensor, if FLC is a obstacle or F is a edge or FRC is a obstacle. Okay, and you should combine this condition for a while loop and you should add advanced motion commands to it. So it will be a hybrid robot which will work as an obstacle avoidance robot as well as edge detection robot. Thank you.